Welcome back, Dark Souls fans, to Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls 3. I remain your host, ShadowFury333, and we're in the middle of Farron Keep, or the next Blighttown. Really, it's not the worst Blighttown that Blighttown could be. It's the nice, framerate-friendly part of Blighttown that they copied. But anyway, we are at that gate. That really mysterious gate. Which apparently was also not completely opened up. Or rather, I doubt it was, since there's still another torch that I haven't lit up. Also, you may notice I went and unhauled myself. Just, why not? Yeah, so there's yet another torch. One more torch, I thought it was two, but nope, only one. So that's not too bad. I'm almost wondering, is it behind that Black Knight I had a problem with? Because if it is, well, I guess I have to deal with that eventually, which I won't. I'll just do what I normally do, and I have to... Whoa. When I have to do my runbacks, which is... Do I have a firebomb? I do have a firebomb. Seems like a perfect place for... Ow. Seems like it would be the perfect place for a firebomb if you'd let me firebomb you. All right. There we go. Perfect. And another undead bone jar, and I get plus two SS flask. Also, I just remembered there's some stuff that needs reading. Let's have some story time with Shadow Fury. First off, Undead Bone Shard. Undead bones that yet burn. Cast it into the shrine bonfire to boost the recovery provided by the Estus Flask. The bonfire cinders are the bones of undead, and a bone that still burns is a fresh cinder indeed. Before feeding upon death, one must first pray to it. How usually cryptic. Okay. But the other things were actually a couple weapons I got several episodes ago, but they seem kind of interesting. So, start with the Irithyll Straight Sword. Straight Sword bestowed upon the Outrider Knights of the Boreal Valley. This weapon is enshrouded in frost and causes frostbite. Every Outrider Knight one day devolves into a beast, constantly hounded by Pontiff Sullivan's black eyes. So this is a great sword. Oh, it's a regular straight sword? Great swords are... Yeah, they're called strict great swords, although... Additional effects of frostbite. I'm kind of curious a little bit, actually. I'm going to... What is that like compared to... That's about the same... Oh, it's a bit heavier. I'll have to switch out some other stuff. It won't be gloves. It'll be pants. All right, I'm curious now. This is an icy sword. Stabbing? Okay, so we have thrusting... Stabbing. Wow, he uses a lot of stamina. That's normal stamina. Jumping attack is like normal long swords. It has... Oops. It does a normal kick. Does normal swipes. It does a big swipe. Okay, so that's about the same as a longsword moveset right now. Yeah, it's pretty typical longsword moveset. And... Yeah. Okay, so it's got a typical longsword moveset. I can easily live with that. And what is it? Okay. Yep. All right. This seems pretty good. I wonder what upgrades. I mean, I wonder what material upgrades it. Very curious to know. Possibly just Titanite. Possibly that the... Not Demon Titanite. What is it? Titanite Scales. Titanite Scales. That's what it's called. So that's the first weapon. Wow. I kind of wish I had checked that out sooner. Although it is a touch stronger than my current sword. Wow. Okay. Actually, it's about the same. Thanks to the way scaling works, it's actually about the same, but it looks like it'll upgrade better. So that was one of them. Sheesh, that was such a big deal. I can't remember what the other one was. Good thing I wrote it down. All right, Butcher Knife. Man-Eater Mildred's thing. Butcher's knife with an oddly large blade wielded by the mad woman haunting the Road of Sacrifices, also known as Man-Eater Mildred. Squarely landed hits restore HP. Back in the Undead Settlement, the woman acquired a taste for human flesh, of which she took glee in partaking. If by the Undead Settlement you mean Blight... Okay, I did not mean to become Guts, but apparently I'm now Guts. I actually wanted to use the Irithyll Straight Sword, not be Guts. Sorry all you Berserk fans out there, but I actually have no familiarity with the series whatsoever. So... It really has no meaning to me. Anyway, let's continue along this nice swampy area. I must say, the real estate prices are probably rock bottom down here. I mean, could be wrong, but no, it's a fixer-upper. Assuming you have several Olympic-sized swimming pools to drain all this muck into. Where does this lead, anyway? I have a really bad feeling this leads back up to that Black Knight that I could have potentially bypassed if I knew how. Oh, well, regardless, it does lead to a bonfire. Oh, wait, I remember now. Supposedly there's a cathedral, which I guess isn't... I thought it was through that gate with all the torches that I'm assuming the torches open, but maybe it's this area. Maybe this is the Cathedral of the Deep. And you are not going to get away with that. Not that easily. Twinkling Titanite. Okay. That's what upgrades the Irithyll Straight Sword. I don't even have to check. It is the sort of thing that Twinkling Titanite upgrades. Twinkling Titanite for weapon reinforcement. Reinforces weapons steeped in strength to +4. These unique weapons cannot be reinforced with ordinary Titanite, nor can they be infused. Unless one uses this Twinkling Titanite, which reinforces these weapons without unraveling their inherent strength. So yeah, rule of thumb. Titanite shards are for normal weapons. Twinkling Titanite are for kind of unique, cool weapons. And Titanite scales for any weapons that I get by talking to the soul infusion guy. By getting soul... boss weapons. Stuff the boss soul gives me. There's one that the Great Wood could give me that's a great sword. I have no particular plans to grab it, but it is only 1,000 souls, and the Great Wood sword isn't... Or Great Wood soul isn't... I don't know, super valuable? It's a few thousand souls on its own, so it might be worth it. I mean, hey, if it's better than the Claymore, that would be good. Be a better weapon. Good to have. And this is an elevator back up. And I would not be surprised if it brings me back up to the Road of Sacrifices. I was actually kind of wondering, what is behind that Black Knight? Because the Black Knight I was fighting, there was a path around it that I noticed. And I thought, maybe I could just bypass the Black Knight entirely and not have to worry about anything. Alright, well that's back down where I was burning. Oh, hey, there's the last one. That's the last big fire, because the other two I've put out. Yeah, that one I put out. The one over here, well, where my cursor just was. And there's one over here I just put out. And now there's the one still burning. Okay. So if we go back down, I'll have to go to my left from the looks of it. That's the way back. Okay, well that's good to know. Glad I got this overview. Is that... an asylum demon? That looks like an asylum demon. That looks very much like an asylum demon. It's like if you were to set an asylum demon on fire, and then you just had this ash asylum demon. You get exactly this in front of me, right now. Let's try the Irithyll Straight Sword. Let's also try having a loaded crossbow. Okay, this... how much damage do you take? Well... whoa, what? Ow. Well, that was not appreciated, sir. You know, I just realized I didn't actually have an ember. I upgraded health a bit recently, but I actually have my health upgraded to the point that I don't need to ember up to get the health that I had initially when I embered up. Still need some extra health, though. But we'll see. As long as I don't get grabbed, that should be fine. But that does look a cool enemy. I want to fight that again. But while we wait for the elevator... oh. Hello. What? Okay. What covenants the old Wolf of Farron? I mean... okay. I'm curious. Because maybe it's like the stone dragon? You fight for wolf bits rather than dragon scales? Well, double check when I get back. I mean, I suppose if I didn't want to be in that covenant, I could always just re-equip Warriors of Sunlight. But, you know, this is a blind run. I shouldn't be too committed to my character design. I mean, the character concept as far as weapons goes, yeah, I want that. And the overall idea of Warrior of Sunlight in spirit, if not in actuality, in terms of the covenant system, definitely. But, you know, this is a blind playthrough. I should be a little bit more flexible. And so I shall. But if and when we die here, Huh. Ah, tail. Okay. Stabbing? Wow, that is totally an Asylum Demon there. That's an Asylum Demon move. For those of you not familiar, that whole thing that was just done there was jump up, slam down. Wait, that's gonna miss me completely. I don't even have to roll. I did have to roll that one, though. Okay, we're good. We're good. Just don't get grabbed. Ah! That rock move is not something that the old Asylum Demon or Stray Demon ever did. I think arguably the magic they did that the Fire Sage Demon and Stray Demon use is close, but not quite the same idea. Slashy, slashy, cut, 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 cut. Am I gonna get my health back? Oops! Whoa, okay. I framed through that one. That was kind of fortunate. Whee! I like this fight. This is the kind of fight that Dark Souls does well. A giant monster that's... Oh, nice. Oh. Giant monster that you basically work and avoid. Oh, that is a Stray Demon. I was not just joking. That actually was the Stray Demon of old. Dark Souls 1, that was an optional boss fight. If you went back to the place you started in, you fought that, well, not that thing. It was a slightly different, it was the same general shape and moveset, and it was this super hard optional boss fight. Worth it. You got your top level upgrade weapons or upgrade item for weapons from it, but yeah. So that was basically a boss fight. Cool. Okay. Soul of a Stray Demon. One of the twisted souls, steeped in strength, used to acquire numerous souls or transpose to... Okay. The Stray Demon, now lacking even a trace of flame, was once the gatekeeper of Lothric. Okay, that's one Dark Souls 1 reference I will be fine with. I know. I complained about Maneater Mildred, and I complained about Siegvert. Didn't really complain about Andre, because who can complain about Andre? Andre's awesome. But the Stray Demon... Yeah, that was a good fight. I cannot complain about that. That's the sort of fight that Dark Souls' combat system works really well in. Also gave me a chance to check out this straight sword. This Irithyll straight sword, and another pilgrim. Is there a shortcut here? Like, I feel like that was kind of the point of this, is that there's a shortcut. There's somewhere I can go that will lead to shortcuts. But it looks like no. Or maybe. Or possibly? Yes? Well, there's something this way. There is very much something this way. Ow. Interesting. All right, well, this is promising. I like this design. I like this level design area setup. Now, I'm going to guess that the shortcut's on this side then. Man, there's a lot of stuff I haven't even explored yet, and... Titanite lizards everywhere. Get back here. Get. Oh, shoot. Not you. You let my Titanite lizard get away. How dare you get. No, this is not where we started, but it's very remarkably similar. Yeah. Ow. Eat frostbite. Whatever that does. I don't know, but I can inflict it now, apparently. And I die trying. Okay, well. Yeah, probably should have healed up. I don't see the shortcut lever. Alright, but that's... And like I said, I'd pray to the wolf. What does the wolf do? Let's find out what the wolf does. Yeah, sure, why not? Watchdogs of Farron. Oh, is this... I'm going to assume that this is something... What is this? Ancient medallion depicting the crest of a wolf. Symbolizes the pact with the old wolf of Farron, equipped to pledge oneself to the watchdogs of Farron. The watchdogs ensure that the warriors sleep in serenity by taking the form of loyal spirits and hunting down those who would trespass the woods of Farron. Yeah, that's what I thought. It's It is another Darkroot Garden Forest Hunters. That's what it was. So that's a Forest Hunters Covenant. So this is Darkroot Blighttown. It's like, I mean, Darkroot Garden, I kind of thought the earlier section that Road of Sacrifices felt a lot like Darkroot Garden. And there is apparently a Forest Hunters Covenant. Because of course there is. But which covenant am I currently in? Warriors of Sunlight. Okay. So I can Forest Hunters if I want to, or Farron Keeper, whatever it is, if I want to. But in the meantime, I should just be far more careful about what I do with Titanite Lizards. Because that seems to be the big weakness at the moment. And the Stray Demon stays dead. Okay. So there actually are enemies that die permanently in Dark Souls 3. Thus far, I had not been confident of such. Really, I hadn't been. I've been finding quite a few enemies that I thought, oh, of course these are going to die. Of course these are going to die. Nope. Big ones, too. That Red-Eye Knight back at, I keep wanting to say Boletaria, High Wall of Lothric? That didn't die. That's still alive. Okay, I am loaded. All right, before I do anything else... Oh, I guess that's why I went the way I did. Wait, really? Well, I have I have stuff to kill. Like these guys. Yeah. Yeah. What? Would you get back here? Oh, come on. You might have Twinkling Titanite. Large Titanite Shard's also good. I will need that pretty... Actually, my crossbow needs that. Wait! Holy crap! I almost missed that! I got Lightning Spear! I got Lightning Spear! I got Lightning Spear, and I need 20 faith for it. I'll be putting a lot of stuff into faith, I guess. Miracle allegedly used by the Warriors of Sunlight. Hurls a Lightning Spear! As the name suggests. The spears inflict lightning damage, providing an effective counter to magic or fire, especially powerful against metal armor and dragons. So anyone who hasn't played the original Dark Souls 1, that's actually... In the intro of Dark Souls 1 are a bunch of knights throwing out, not Lightning Spear, but like the third level version of it. It's like there's three versions of it. Lightning Spear, Great Lightning Spear, and Sunlight Spear. And they're throwing out the Sunlight Spears, but basically it's the same idea. In order to kill a bunch of dragons. Because this is a world that started by, well, in the human sense, by murdering dragons. Because dragons were getting in the way. Now, I just got so... Caught up. What the heck did I just pick up? Okay, I don't even remember what I just picked up. I'm so excited about Lightning Spear, I'm not even paying attention to anything else. I've been waiting for Lightning Spear this whole time. I actually have a reason to invest in Ashen Estus flasks. Oh, right, it was a shield. That's what it was. It was one of the Dragon Crest Shield. A knight's shield engraved with a crest depicting a dragon. One of the enchanted blue shields. The Dragon Crest Shield greatly reduces fire damage. Right, and the regular crest shield reduces magic damage, assuming it's anything like Dark Souls 1, and another dragon, another dead dragon. Huh. Now, I just want to point out something here. So anyone who's played Dark Souls 2 will be familiar with the Forest of Fallen Giants, because it's the first area, pretty much. One of the things I didn't like about Forest of Fallen Giants, I pointed it out a bit earlier as well, was the way that you'd find areas you couldn't access, but you could see the floor, and it looked really bad. But it almost looks like you could access it if you jumped. This is a much better way of blocking stuff off for this kind of castle gate region. Works a lot better. Anyhow, biggest next concern is that particular... I'm not loaded. This particular Titanite Lizard is going to be a pain in the butt. No, I'm not even going to bother. I cannot easily get through these guys. You die... Yay, I got health up. Are you alive? No. In fact, you are partially incorporeal. Actually, you're either incorporeal or completely impassable and unmovable. Where's the shortcut lever to this? There's gotta be one. I mean, I'll grant that it's... Oh, wait, no. How do I get back? I'll grant that it's not that hard to get in, but then I just realized, how do I get back? Yeah. Ah. Well. Eat backstab. Well done redeeming your free backstab. I hope it was as enjoyable for you as it was for me. Somehow, however, I doubt it. Okay. Gotta remember to use four from time to time. Would you be quiet? Some people are trying to sleep around here. Ow. I've got to use my two-handed mode more often. I don't need that much focus points. Alright, so I was up here. I found the area that looked remarkably similar to one I'd been to before. Didn't really find anything of interest up here, except maybe a lever? Not a lever! No levers around here anywhere. Okay. There is a way back. So I guess that works. And another way to one's death. Well, this was a pleasant detour. What was I even trying to accomplish anyway? Gotta be honest, I don't really remember. Well, whatever. Stabbing people, I guess. Yeah, I was trying to accomplish something. Stuff down here? I was trying to get through a different area. Got distracted by this path. And found all these Titanite lizards, one of which I still need to kill. Actually, two of which I still need to kill. I'll do that off camera. I wonder how I get to that other one over here, though. I guess now wouldn't be a bad time to figure out if quitting and reloading the game gets... You know, actually, let's do that. I mean, I wouldn't normally do that on camera, but you know what? It's something that I think really should be tested, because in Dark Souls 1, you could do this. In Dark Souls 2, you couldn't. So I'm curious if it works in Dark Souls 3, or how it works in Dark Souls 3. Can you quit and reload? Or is it when you next go to a bonfire? The answer is... quit and reload! Wow, okay. That was unexpected, but apparently, yeah, you can just quit and reload, and that will get you back Titanite lizards. Down you go. What do I get? Heavy gem. Okay. And there was another one over here, right next to the dragon, which has not spotted me yet, so it wasn't totally spooked. Yeah! Ah! I mean, just the important thing is that they don't vanish. There we go. Another large Titanite shard. Okay. So that was totally worth it and very good science. So now we know Dark Souls 3, you quit and reload as you did in Dark Souls 1, and all the Titanite lizards come back. Yeah, I don't know. I'm not really a huge fan of that. I kind of like the way it worked in 2, honestly. I mean, it was a touch annoying, I suppose, but on the other hand, it did mean you kind of had to think about stuff a bit more than... Oops. So there was nothing on there that I needed to get. Doesn't look like it. Anyway, yeah, so... that was one thing about Dark Souls 2 that was kind of nice. You didn't have that for totally free. It's like you had to deal with the... had to think about how I'm going to deal with the enemies first. I mean, I don't really mind the fact that Titanite lizards are that easy to get. It's just... I didn't mind the way that Dark Souls 2 did it either. This straight sword is pretty cool. It's my current... oh, durability lasts for a while too. Nice. I mean, durability in general actually lasts for a fairly long time in 3. Oh, is there any way to that corpse? Anyway, I'm just going to go upgrade some of my weapons, so I will be back shortly. Okay, small back, and then I'll leave again, but I was right about Twinkling Titanite. However, thankfully... it only takes one Twinkling Titanite, then two, then probably three. It's probably 1 to 3 to 4 to 5. Because usually Twinkling items max out at +5. Although it did say +4 in the description of Twinkling Titanite, so I don't know how that works. But yeah, so a little bit less costly than it is with Titanite shards. Anyway, be back again. Holy crap. Okay, once again back, because turns out Havel's ring you get from killing that stray demon. Guess what we're getting? Actually, I'll think about that for a sec, because Havel's ring is a super awesome ring. I'm just going to get it anyway. I'm not going to spend the... because seriously, why would I drop down when I need to just spend some souls? Weird. Anyway. Okay, let's... Soul of an Unknown Traveler... because I can get that. I mean, I don't know if I necessarily want it, but holy crap, Havel's ring has been generally... well, in 2 they had the Royal Soldier's Ring rather than Havel's ring. Oops. Same general idea, though. Equipment load, especially given the Endurance Vitality split, because Endurance in 1 gave you the equip load as well as stamina. It makes Havel's ring a lot more useful. Granted, it sacrifices a ring slot, and then some other stuff. So basically these are all the things the demon, soul of a demon, doesn't matter which one, just any demon. So I guess there are more demons. Okay, cool.
Now.
Anyway, thank you for Havel's ring. That'll be really nice to have. Don't really need the blue tier stone ring, and Havel's ring means I'm at 60% equip load. Although, I don't know if I want to wear... What else do I want to wear? I mean, the Lothric Knight armor isn't that nice. The armor I have is... like, it doesn't look that great, honestly. Although, Lothric leggings, I was always trying to get those in. There we go. That looks worse. I mean, it's better protection. Is it that much better protection? Not that much better protection, honestly. In fact, Fallen Knight trousers are almost a bit better in their own right. And I could put on other better gauntlets. Fallen Knight gauntlets. I wonder if there's any Elite Knight stuff. Alright, well, let's go with this for now. So that gives me an absorption total of 22% physical. Nice. So a little over a fifth of all the damage taken physically gets absorbed before I have to worry about defense or anything. Awesome! Let's go back. And I have Havel's ring, which I was kind of hoping for. And I can get Estus Flask plus two. Okay, so bonfire level... That's interesting. I say that's interesting because... when it says bonfire level, like, I'm not sure if it means like kindling or like bonfire aesthetics of two. Because, I mean, in one, you'd burn stuff at the bonfire to get... No, you can't do it here, so I don't know. Also, what am I doing? I cannot attune Lightning Spear. Never mind. That's for when I actually get the faith for it. So... in two, you could use an item called the Bonfire Aesthetic that would allow you to basically make an area like it was New Game Plus. In one, on the other hand, you had the kind of the opposite, where you could you'd burn humanity in a bonfire and it would give you extra Estus. And now to stab you on the way down. Yeah, plunging attack! Ow. I like this straight sword. Oops. Come on, jump off. Oh, or just go down, whatever. Ah, okay, let's think about this. Oh, you know what I'm betting? I'm betting the Rusted Iron Ring, or it will be Rusted Iron Ring. It's about to say ore equivalent, but no. The way Dark Souls 3 has been so far, it's not ore equivalent. It is outright Rusted Iron Ring. I bet the way it works, is, or what you get it, is to kill the boss of this area. Ow. Heck, that was rude. Totally predictable, but rude. As was that, you spat on me. I'm gonna enjoy cutting you. Another Titanite Shard, which is actually enough to upgrade something to plus two. Actually, I don't care though right now, because I don't have anything to upgrade to plus two since I'm not using the longsword. I'm using this Irithyll straight sword instead, since I really like it. And wish I checked it out 5 episodes ago when I actually got it, rather than now. But hey, better late than never. Alright. So, I mentioned before, I noticed to the left is the option to take. That is how I get somewhere. Going to my left. Alright, well, this is going to be a bit painful, but whatever. Of course I'm poisoned. Nameless stuff. Okay. A lot of knights around here. A lot of knights in various states of disrepair. I'm only really doing that because I want to make sure I actually have... I can read stuff. Alright, Nameless! Here we are. Armor of a nameless knight. Oops. Crafted with a thin metal greatly reinforced by a grooved finish. With no other description. Kind of makes sense. Yeah. Okay, well, I guess if they're nameless, no one would really know. Heal up. Also, yeah, I put two in Ash Nessus Flask too, which I actually realize is kind of worthless now because I don't yet have Lightning Spear. When I get Lightning Spear, it'll be totally worth it. But at the moment, it's a bit of a waste. Now, what are you? I also stocked up on bolts. Well, I don't know what you are. You look like another demon. I hope you are. I rather enjoy fighting demons. Just not in this swamp area. Ow. Wow. Alright. Deal with you now. There we go. Whoa, okay. Are those bleed? Nope, they're not bleed. Ow. Well, you aren't going to be too hard to kill. And you are probably not a demon. Probably something far more mild. Well, if I've got the Ash Nessus Flask, I might as well use the Ash Nessus Flask. That wasn't too bad. Alright. Let's keep going. So like I said, left side is probably my best bet. That's another one of those. And that's another bit of solid ground to fight it on. And that's probably the last bonfire. Or not last bonfire, last fire I need to worry about lighting or unlighting or whatever. Alright. Let's get rid of poison again. Just so I don't have to worry about it while I'm fighting this guy. Cut. Ow. Ow. Wow, okay. I feel really stupid for having not healed with Estus. That classic roguelike mistake. Well, this isn't a roguelike, but classic mistake. Classic action RPG mistake. Classic roguelike mistake. Doesn't matter. It's a classic mistake. I have stuff. I don't need to use it. I'll do fine, right? Right? No. The answer is no. How much poison must I have? Oh, I only have the two. I thought I had more in storage. I guess that's just rotten pine resin. Plunge! Ow. Well, I killed two of them. That's better. Okay, so how am I going to quickly get over there? That's what I got here. This is the way over to... Oh, of course, what am I thinking? I have a crossbow. I have a crossbow for a reason. Because dealing with some of these enemies without a crossbow is a pain in the butt. Probably load the crossbow, so I actually can deal with these enemies. Okay, I think I know where to go. If I can just avoid poison. Sitting around, waiting around, getting my poison gone away. There we go. Awesome. And this is where I can fight this enemy without having to worry about poison. Are those things? Oh, they're like spirits or something? I mean, it's clearly just damage, but I have no idea how much damage it deals relative to the tree branch, but the tree branch is scary as heck, so I'm not gonna underestimate anything. Whoa! Ow. Okay, no, they're both scary. Ow! Sheesh! No joke! Alright, let's get into a better island. Take cover briefly while the skulls hit the tree. Ow! I misread that attack completely. Well, I had no time to heal. Could benefit from it, though. Just couldn't. Because I was going to get slammed. Actually, I probably could have. I'm trying to learn that lesson, you know? Be too aggressive, and then you end up living. Or at least if you're not aggressive enough, you end up dying. Oh well, anyway, we'll get back to that in the next episode. Until then, have a good night.